Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I would be grateful if you took a few moments to listen to the following short safety announcements. On hearing the fire alarm, we would ask everyone to evacuate the building immediately. Please leave in a calm and orderly manner using the exits which are located at the front and the rear of the hall. Then make your way to the assembly point at the front of the physics building located at the car park side of the hall opposite the main building. We would ask you to remain there until instructed otherwise. Please do not attempt to re-enter the building, even if the alarms have been silenced, as this does not always mean the emergency is over. I would also like to take this opportunity to ask you to silence all mobile phones now for the duration of the ceremony. Thank you for your cooperation, and we trust you enjoy your visit to Queen's University.
The world is changing at an unprecedented pace. Every industry is embracing change, drawing on a new wealth of insights and tools to advance in today's connected society. At Queen's University, we have a bold ambition to lead the way in the challenges we see ahead. Every day, we touch thousands of lives in our pursuit of excellence. Finding the solutions to real-world issues and inspiring research to have real-world impact. We are protecting the cybersecurity of billions of internet users. We are at the forefront of conflict resolution, making a difference to the lives of children, families, and communities across the world. We are working with industry to develop new technologies. We are creating access to safe, nutritious food for a growing population. And we're at the forefront of major medical breakthroughs, making a real impact on people's lives. We give amazing minds a place to do amazing things in a university fit for the 21st century. We are the heartbeat of one of Europe's fastest growing cities, in a country where the hospitality, welcome, and warmth of our people is legendary. Together, we are meeting the challenges of our time head on. Developing our students to be the leaders of tomorrow with the confidence and innovation to engage in an ever-evolving global culture. Together, we are shaping a better world.
Congratulations on your recent academic achievements and welcome to the Queen's alumni community. I really hope that the sun is shining for you today, or that the rain isn't too bad. The successful completion of your degree is testament to your hard work and the support you've received from school and faculty staff, and of course, your friends, family, and your champions. I hope that you will be inspired by and remember your experience at Queen's as a student. I have no doubt that each one of you has the potential to achieve greatness, no matter where life takes you. You now join a distinguished network of over 200,000 past Queen's students who have enhanced and continue to enhance life in Northern Ireland and across the world. The impact of graduates can be seen through their contributions to business, healthcare, sport, engineering, social justice, and many, many more industries. I hope to have the opportunity to meet many of you in person at upcoming events over the months and years to follow, and to hear your stories as both a student and graduate. Wherever you travel, Queen's will continue to be part of your journey, sharing your success, supporting you through difficult times, highlighting exciting opportunities, and providing access to networks of graduates in your field of expertise. We'll keep you up to date as your relationship with Queen's transforms from a student for a few years to a graduate forever, and help you take advantage of the excellent ongoing support from the Careers, Employability and Skills team here at Queen's. But we can't do any of that if we don't know where to find you. Find some time today to make sure that we can continue to contact you by following the instructions on screen. You'll be glad you did. I'd like to offer you the warmest congratulations and best wishes for the future from everyone at the Development and Alumni Relations Office. We can't wait to hear all about the wonderful things you will do next.
Please rise to receive the academic procession. Good afternoon, everyone. It's my great pleasure to extend to you a warm welcome on this very special occasion to our graduands, to parents, family and friends, and to members of staff behind me. It's my honour to declare open this congregation for the conferment of degrees and presentation of diplomas and certificates. Please be seated. I now call upon Professor Aaron Moll, Dean of Research in the Faculty of Medicine, Health and Life Sciences, and member of the School of Biological Sciences and Institute of Global Food Security, to address the Assembly.
Provost Chancellor, members of Senate, fellow staff, ladies and gentlemen, guests, visitors, and most importantly, of course, graduands from the School of Biological Sciences, welcome to this summer graduation event. What a day this will be for you all. Personally, I'm particularly excited to address you today because, believe it or not, it's been 40 years exactly this year that I walked across from the sticks in the countryside to Queen's University Belfast to pursue my interest in biology. At a time when there wasn't a school of biological sciences, but everything was divided up into its disciplinary areas. So we had departments of botany and departments of biochemistry and microbiology and genetics and zoology. And of course, they all have now come together under the umbrella of the School of Biological Sciences, of which we all belong. So I've been here a long time. I did leave for 3 years to go abroad, but the school called me back, and I've had the privilege to serve as a member of staff in the school since that time, since 1995. So the good thing is there's many of your faces are familiar to me, so it's good to see you here. My goodness, you scrub up well. So soon, graduands, you will be walking across this stage to pick up your degrees, the end point of your journey at Queen's, for many of you at least. From when you took up your undergraduate or postgraduate degree programs, and of course when you started them, you didn't realize what was coming. What a time you have had. We did not realize COVID-19 would hit us in March 2020, but I realize many of you were in your first year, some of you were in your second, some of you in your third, and of course that changed everything. What we thought would be your experience, what you thought would be your experience, was very different. But you know what? You showed many traits in getting through this because you've got here today, so you've been successful. Traits of agility, resilience, the ability to dig deep in a very unpredictable environment. So you've all made it, and well done for that. I think because of that, we want to pay particular tribute to your ability to cope with a crisis, to your ability to adopt new ways of working, new ways of living even during the pandemic, and ending up here today successfully completing your degree programs. Therefore, I think this celebration pays particular tribute, not just to your academic achievement, but in a way to your ability to cope with major challenges, in a way your ability to find a way. That, I'm sure, will stand you in good stead as you look to the future. So you should be proud of yourselves, as we all on the stage, and I know your support teams are, off you for your achievements. There are exciting times ahead when you go out of here with your certificate and your degree under your belt. So obviously COVID has been a downside of your journey and suggests bad timing, but there's also particularly good timing that I want to call out. For example, you will know as a Russell Group University, research looms large through our undergraduate programs, through our postgraduate programs, and obviously those who do PhDs focus on research. And we have been assessed for the quality of our research in the School and Institute of Global Food Security. And across the UK, we came first equal. First equal in the quality of the research we do and the impact that that research has. That's a terrific achievement for everyone in the school. And remember, you guys were here when that happened, so you can claim your small piece of your contribution to that success. So well done. With respect to perfect timing, what a time to be doing biological sciences or working in the life sciences. We see many global challenges in front of us. And what we see is that our discipline is front and center to tackling many of those. These challenges, as you know, will include climate change and the effects it has on our environment, the effects it has on biodiversity, food production with a growing human population, And yet we have to do that by reducing the footprint of farming on the environment as we strive towards net zero. Antimicrobial resistance, which is a continuing scourge of health. The solutions to that are being found through natural products, through such activities as marine bioprospecting. And of course, disease. We know now that diseases of animals, zoonotic diseases, can cause global pandemics that, in a way, change the world. Research in all of these areas ties the School of Biological Sciences together under a single roof, as you know, up on Chlorine Gardens, a beautiful new building. So with that backdrop from your programs of study, many of you will have the tools to contribute positively to areas of critical need in society, both locally and globally. As you take your next steps, please use them to make a difference, because as graduates, you will shape the future of our society. But when you do that, please do it with care. It is important to make sure that while you strive to be the best that you can be, you're always kinder than necessary. Those are words by Jeremy Kent. One thing that I hope many of you realize during your time at Queen's is the importance of teams. And no, I don't mean the video conferencing platform that most of us grew to loathe during lockdown. What I mean is working together to solve problems and enhance outcomes. We always work better as a team than we do individually. And of course, when we look at the global challenges, some of which I've touched upon, you will realize that it requires teamwork. It requires teams from right across the disciplines to try and solve those problems, coming together, working better, bringing in more different types of expertise. So always look to that, to the opportunities to work in teams and enhance the teams that you play for. But of course, in this interdisciplinarity, for us, life sciences is at the epicenter. With respect to the teams notion, of course, you all have your own teams. You had staff at Queen's who were helping you on the way through your programs. You have peers who were assisting you, friends and family, all encouraging and supporting you through very, very difficult times. So you have your own team around you, and I think it's an apt time now, maybe if the graduands, if you would please stand up and applaud each other for your success and the teams who've helped you for the help that they provided. So. You can sit down again. I particularly also want to call out all of those who've given up their time to contribute in other ways to Queen's University Belfast, those that have embraced life within the university. Many of you enjoyed and contributed to the myriad of clubs and societies. Thank you for your contributions. Of course, it's those of you that stood as reps for NSS and as student representatives feeding back information from your peers on the quality of what we do. Those processes are critically important to what we do and inform us. They tell us about good practice and things that we do well, but also tell us things that we continue and can continually improve, and we strive to do that on a regular basis. I also want to thank particularly those who contributed through volunteering and through community projects. You made a difference. Thank you for that. And of course, to those who helped contribute to the many demands during the COVID-19 pandemic, or at least at the lockdown periods, through diagnostic testing. Thank you all. Thank you all for helping make Queen's the great place that it is today. Finally, I hope for those of you who will be leaving Queen's, I hope you look back on us fondly. We certainly cherish your time here. Look back on us fondly and tell us about the exciting new things that you do, the things that you discover, and the difference that you make. We want to hear about that, and of course we have alumni schemes set up where you can keep in touch with us, and we would very much want you to do that. So please keep in touch, but remember, you have achieved all this in particularly challenging times, so we salute you. Congratulations, and much good luck for the future.
Thank you very much, Professor Moll. Can I now ask all the graduands to please rise? In the name and by the authority of the university, I confer on you and those whose names appear on the graduation list the degrees, diplomas, and certificates to which you are entitled, and for which you who are present will be individually presented by your head of school. Please be seated.
Prue Vice Chancellor, I present to you candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in the School of Biological Sciences, Holly Sarah Elizabeth Bradford. Owen Manus Cunningham. Connor Doolan. Anthony Clive George. Brendan Gilbride. Joshua McDool. Shannon Marie McLaughlin. Shea Terence Molyneux. Nicole Maria Fowler Sadowski. Sophie Helen Redpath. Hao Wang. And for Master of Science in Advanced Food Safety, Pankaj Roy. Subbalakshmi Shirish. Sheeta Vanakana. And for Business for Agri-Food and Rural Enterprise Business Communication, Lindsay Hawkes. Beth Ann Kavanagh. Cormac Patrick McCurvey. April Sophie Tyner. Gemma Mary Devlin. Paul Robert Elliott. Geraldine Flynn. Zara Gabby. Naomi Helen Jones. And for Business for Agri-Food and Rural Enterprise Innovation Management, Brenda Callahan. And for Global Food Security, Food Safety, Joanne Burtonshaw. Margaret Emerin Amy Irwin. And for Leadership for Sustainable Development, Katrina Comerford. Theanu Stokadu. Suma Duda. And for Molecular Biology and Biotechnology, Nora Moffley Alanzi. Marie McCarran. David Anthony Patton. Deanne Sanuvala Herrero. Charity Binda. Ritvik Rajesh. Dana Adriana Rivera Devitt. Raksha Dajudi Mahendra Kumar. Sharyu Jagdish Jagtap. Muhammad Esmerfil Helmi bin Shahabuddin Helmi. And for Master in Science Biochemistry, Holly Angela Duncan Todd. Gemma Marie Coyle. And for Biochemistry of the Professional Studies, Tara Marie Bertholin. Catherine Marie Devlin. Harry James McFarlane. Cassandra Karen Dalrymple. Sarah Ann McAlevey. And for Biological Sciences, Sarah Deacon. And for Biological Sciences with Professional Studies, Ryan McChrystal. And for Food Quality, Safety and Nutrition, Rachel Ellen Moore. And for Food Quality, Safety and Nutrition with Professional Studies, Naomi Teresa Anderson. And for Food Science and Food Security, Holly Nicole Tracy. And for Food Science and Food Security with Professional Studies, Catherine Elizabeth Douglas. Rebecca Susan Murray. Liam Nicholas Rock. Aveen Rose Trainer. And for Marine Biology, Jack Patrick Burton. Amber Margaret Keenan. And for Microbiology, Cara Sheila Coyle. Nicole Jacqueline Haveron. Clodagh Mary McGennady. Claire Ann Nelson Alphon. Jack Robert Daniel Smith. And for Microbiology with Professional Studies, Finton Thomas McMahon. And for Zoology, Rachel Alexander Hunter. Aoife Mary McGrath. Kira Evelyn Henry. And for Zoology with Professional Studies, Sarah Jane Gray, Michael Joseph McCoy, Rebecca Emma McKinney, and for Bachelor of Science, Agricultural Technology, Hannah Elizabeth McGee, Jack Stewart, James Kerr-Waugh, Amy Sarah Agnew, Sophie Jade Armstrong, Kirsty Bonnie Blair, Courtney Louise Colgan, Harry Paul Conan, Ben Crawford, Zach Elkin, Ella Catherine Hawkes, Rachel Margaret Jordan, Ethan McFerrin, David McNamee, Sam David Morrison, James Alan Rulston, Megan Tate, Robert John Foster, Joanne Moore, Caitlin Alana Alexandra Platts, Louise Sheila Williamson, and for Agricultural Technology with Professional Studies, Bruna Dempster, Joshua Andrew McClements, Ellen Elizabeth McClure, Sarah Amy Spence, Sophie Amber Thompson, Mina Louise McCloskey, Brian Sean McNaughton, James McPeak, Daniel William Sloan, Kieran Patrick Monaghan, Dara Patrick Tracy, and for biochemistry, Katie Jennifer Jane Brown, Dara Morgan, Andrew McGrath, Aaron McLennan, and for biochemistry with professional studies, Camilla Anshiko, Ellie Beth Green, Cornelia Juski, Sarah Christiana Da Costa Martins, Matthew Graham Wallace, Charlotte Frances Agnes Montgomery, Ellie Oliver, and for biological sciences, Jade May Harrison Elliott, Matthew Luke Houston, Brogan Christine Allen, Michael Clark, Shifra Mason, Faye Elizabeth Mason, Shay McMillan, Hannah Louise Miller, Ryan Murphy, Holly Ann Catherine O'Kane, Sarah Elizabeth Topping, Jonathan Michael Anderson, Thomas Patrick Shane Glynn, Henry O'Neill, Jessica Revels Dawson, and for biological sciences with professional studies, Rory Declan Baird, Catherine Mary Dodds, Joss Victoria Glenn, Colm Patrick Hollywood, Lauren Kirsty McTamney, Gerald Rice, John Paul Wilkins, Paul Johnston, Orla Therese McShane, David James Mulholland, Jingming So Young Lom, and for environmental management, Evan Black, Catherine Grace McElherron, Oisin Connor Morris, Ryan Abdul Khalik Ridha Abalushi, Ryan Dennis Devaney, Oisin Michael Duff, Orla Quinn, Amy Smith, Davin Michael Cummings, Robert Graham Paul, and for environmental management with professional studies, Jessica Amanda Elliott, Sophie McPeak, Tyler Noel Desmond Curry, and for food quality, safety and nutrition, Thint Nai Chi Nong. Food quality, safety and nutrition with professional studies, Rachel Isabella Miriam Black, Alana Connie Cassidy, Fiona Gilchrist, Amy Deborah Irvine, Nicole Carey Mackay, Una Mary McCune, Ellen Ann McKnight, Sarah Louise Quinn, Sarah Jane Shaw, Niamh Karen Brown, Peter Richard Gracie, Karis Rose Linus, Amy Susanna Noble, Claire Elizabeth Ramsey, Cora Ellen Robinson, Elise Francis Toole. And for Food Science and Food Security of the Professional Studies, Jenna Grace Scott. And for Marine Biology, Nicola Elizabeth Connor, Jonathan Stuart McDowell. And for Marine Biology of the Professional Studies, Hannah Elizabeth Clark, Katie Rebecca Kerr, Lara Roisin Walsh, and for Microbiology, Rhea Alana Ellen Balmer, Anna Elizabeth Lees, Karen Louise Mellon, Luke Daniel Murphy, Nathan Robert Qua, Jessica Christina Allison, Fiona Claire Bennett, Patrick Peter Graham, Thomas John Keenan, Justine Law, Olivia Imogen Mulderig, Sophie O'Neill, Rory Quinn, David Bell, and for Microbiology and Professional Studies, Emmett Campbell, Alexander Kennedy Fleming, Kyle Joseph Laurie, Aileen Lynch, Robbie Joseph Kuhn, Kieran Oliver Quinn, and for Zoology, Sarah Sophia Dorian, Amy Fraser, Victoria Cleveland Harvey, Ben McInoy, Anna Florence McLean, Ashlyn Orrell, Zachary Ruse, Richard Michael Clark, Jordan Crane, Olin Joseph Duffy, Oisin Loughran, Ellen Maria McNally, David Murphy, Victoria Murray, Anna Proctor, Jessica Olivia Ramage, Nathaniel Jake Gilbert, and for Zoology with Professional Studies, Chloe Jane Cumming, Oisin John Hill, Emma Catherine McKinney, Harry James Gibbons, and Craig Melvin Latimer.
Well, what a wonderful graduation ceremony. It took a little while to get everybody warmed up, but it's been a real privilege for all of us on the stage to share this graduation with this wonderful group of graduates in front of me. As Professor Moll said, you come from a widely diverse group of disciplines, all of which are crucial to planetary health, public health, and personal health. And we really want to encourage you as you either continue your studies or go into the workforce, that what you have learned at Queen's will continue to equip you to make a difference in the positive for the world around us, because we have so many major challenges to tackle in the near future. So congratulations on this very significant milestone for you as graduates and for you as families. We have enjoyed really sharing this celebration with you. And as a university, we are really proud of what you have achieved. And we hope you're also proud of your university. As a graduate of Queen's, you will remain part of this family, part of this community. And we hope some of you will stay on to do some further study. Some of you will go and come back to partake in further study. But we hope all of you will stay part of the family as alumni of this great university, and stay in touch through the Alumni Relations Office. There will be many opportunities for you to be updated, but also to contribute back into the university through those students who will follow after you, through supporting them in their education and with placements. So we hope you stay absolutely part of us. We wish you every success for the future, and all of us look forward to hearing about your achievements in the future. But before we close today's ceremony, there are some people who haven't been able to attend who would like to add their congratulations by video. And we'll have a short video presentation now from a number of your teachers and our Chancellor.
Dear students, well done. Congratulations. It's a pleasure to see you graduating today, and it's been an honor to be part of your journey here at Queen's. So well done, and let's celebrate.
I'd like to say a word of congratulations to each and every one of you. You have so much to be proud of. Not only have you completed your degree, but you've completed your degree throughout a global pandemic, so you've done remarkably well. I look forward to hearing how many of you get on in your future careers and keeping in touch with you. All the best.
Never lose your enthusiasm and willingness to learn. Congratulations.
I would like to say congratulations to everyone on completing their course of study here at Queen's. I wish you all every possible success in the future, and please do keep in touch.
I'd just like to thank the AgTech class especially. You guys have been so incredibly polite and such a genuinely nice group of individuals to work with, to teach during the course of the last two semesters. So a big thank you from me. I wish you all the best in your future endeavours. Make sure you enjoy the summer break. You all definitely deserve it. Take care now.
Hello, biochemistry students. Well done and congratulations on your achievement today. You've shown that your dedication to your studies meant that not even a global pandemic could get in your way. So you should be so proud of your commitment and your resilience that you've displayed in order to lead to this success. It's been a pleasure getting to know some of you and teaching and interacting with you over the last few years. And I hope you have at least some positive memories from the biochemistry pathway. This does not mark the end, but think of this as the beginning to the next step of your life. And I wish you every success in the future. If I have one piece of advice, is to choose a path that you enjoy, be that in biochemistry or not. Just make sure that you love what you do.
To our food safety, quality and nutrition students, well done for your success. Wherever you're gonna work, in the industry, everywhere, just keep in touch. Food, is there anything else more important? No. Well done, guys.
As Chancellor of Queen's University, I would like to offer my sincere congratulations to all of our graduating students. After 2 years without summer graduations, I'm delighted that you can all celebrate together in person to mark this very special occasion. You know, graduation is a significant milestone in every student's career, and today is an opportunity for the university to formally recognize your hard work and congratulate you on your success. Your graduation is even more special as the circumstances in which you've completed your studies has made your achievements simply remarkable. I know the journey has not been easy, but you've demonstrated incredible resilience, agility, and determination in adapting to new circumstances to achieve your goals. You're graduating at a time of major challenges and change across the world, but it's also, I believe, a time of great opportunity and potential. So, class of 2022, please use your knowledge, your skills, your talents to help us shape a better world. Our society needs people like each of you, creative, critically good at thinking and doing, problem solvers, who can make real differences in transforming lives and societies. So as you close this important chapter in your life and begin a new one, I wish you the very, very best as you go out into that world that awaits. Please be a force for positive change and always be proud of the fact that you are a Queen's graduate. Because Queen's is certainly proud of you, as are your parents, families, and friends celebrating with you today. Congratulations again, and best wishes for every success in the future.
It's now my honor to declare closed this congregation for the conferment of degrees and the presentation of diplomas and certificates, and invite our new graduates and recipients to join the academic procession as it leaves the hall. We would ask parents and friends to leave after the procession, and please join us in the quad for some refreshments. Thank you.
Alumni Office was established to ensure that the relationship between graduates and alma mater becomes lifelong. Many people will have forged lasting personal and professional friendships while at Queen's, and the ongoing alumni outreach program aims to keep Queen's men and Queen's women in touch with the university and, of course, with each other. In time, alumni will make return visits to Queen's for reunions, public lectures, social and academic events, and perhaps further study. It's particularly important to stay in contact if careers are pursued overseas, and for this reason, Queen's now has a number of graduate organisations based both here in Northern Ireland and throughout the world in Canada, America, the Far East, Africa, and Northern Europe. So, graduation should not mark the end of your association with Queen's. Through the Alumni Office, those friends, contacts, and memories can last a lifetime.